Today we have what we call a top two primary, and this is because of some court cases that changed the open primary that we had, that we loved here. What the pick two would do is change the primary system again to something a little more like the open primary. In it, all the candidates that are on the ballot, you would be able to choose your favorite and your second favorite, and so basically ranking your top two picks. And then the candidates that would advance would be the candidates that, using a ranked choice algorithm, got the most votes. And here's the important distinction. Today, the person who got the most votes and the second most votes goes forward. But you can get some very odd behaviors. Imagine if there were three Republicans in the primary and only one Democrat. All three Republicans could, in a Republican district, could split up the vote, and you could end up, a Democrat could get the most votes and go forward. And that wasn't what the voter intent was at all. You get a truer picture of the intent of the voter in this style of voting. In Pierce County, they did a version of ranked choice voting, and voters really, by at least as they explained in their survey, weren't at all confused by it. They understood the process of rating the candidates. But the pick two primary is different than what they did in Pierce County, because in Pierce County, that sought to eliminate the primary. And I think the primary election plays a very important role in politics. A lot of people aren't really paying close attention to the election until the primary hits them, and then they start looking, and then so I keep the primary process in place.